Hi, this is Rich Nutvila, and we're going to work on Sean. And how are you going to start? What are you would like to address first?
Well, we know that he has problems regarding the food, like, you know, has to get a specific amount, not too much, not too little, and stuff. His stomach area, and also, like, you know, in the last session we had a thing with Mantis and the energy and different things, and it was affecting his body. So I would like to scan him, like, see if I pick up anything new, and go from there. You know, like, more entities, maybe energy blocks, maybe some agreements and different things, see what's up.
We're getting some reads on entities, big time.
All right.
So we can be sure to tune in on that. Do you want to just jump in, or you want me to, like, look at when Sean's issues first started happening? Do you have any idea?
I feel like we can just jump in. Like, I would like to scan his body, because, like, you know, we started, like, this is how we started, like, last time. Like, you checking out how it, like, went and all.
Mm-hmm.
And now I want to, like, continue the process, see how he's doing, if there's any energy breaks and different things, and go from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you got a place to start, and you know what you're going to look into?
Yeah, I'll just, like, scan his body and go from there.
Okay.
Okay.
And I'll guide you. Start.
So I'm scanning his body, and as I start looking at it, like, I spot these, like, dark clusters or dark energy spheres around his body. One is in his stomach and his chest, neck, and shoulder area. That's sort of like when I'm noticing them. As I'm looking through it, scanning, like, it's as if, like, they pick me up, like, oh, like, there they come, they see us. And so they are afraid and they scatter around. So, you know, I can try removing those things, making sure that they're fully out, because, like, right now these are like cockroaches running from the light and all.
Yeah, sure.
So I'll do that first.
Yeah, good idea.
Okay, go for it. I got to say something, but, like, I'm seeing this being. It reminds me of this hammer shark, if that's how you say it.
Hammerhead shark?
Yeah, hammerhead shark. Because it's like black entity. It's, like, very dense, made out of a lot of these other beings. And it's working like a radio, I guess. And the head, like, you know, like, it looks like a hammer. And, like, it's as if, like, these two spheres that can get information from the surroundings, pick up, like, other entities from other people, different things, and it just, like, enhances the whole feeling state. So the smallest things in the surroundings or, like, his life will trigger him and cause, like, this fear, panic, worries, concerns, and just, like, really mess with him. So that's what I'm picking up so far.
Mm-hmm. Like an amplifier.
Yeah.
It takes a sound or it takes an emotion or an energy phenomenon and amplifies it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And that also is connected to the other entities. In his body and other people around him, the surroundings, like wherever he might go, that entity is as if, like, it's attached to him and it's following Sean, like Sean. But that entity is, like, more, it needs other beings nearby to cause damage and stuff.
Okay.
And so, like, it can, like, pick up, like, a transmission from our beings, like, whatever, that being, like, oh, what if. And another entity can have worries, concerns, and that hammerhead shark being-looking entity will pick up the emotion or whatever it is that the other beings have, and it's gonna amplify it and make Sean feel it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Continue.
So, yeah, I'll get rid of that being.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I got rid of the entities, and I'm, like, scanning, like, you know, are there anything else in this, energy surroundings and different things. And what I'm picking up is, like, probably one of the past lives. And right now, it's as if, like, part of him, because of the recent incidents that have affected his body, as if, like, it's resistance of living. And I think, like, you know, in past life, he had instances where he killed other people. Reasons I don't know yet why we have those lives, but because of taking away lives of others, he probably feels guilt or whatever, and because of that, he sort of, like, those incidents where he took away food from others, or, like, were, like, following orders and just torturing others, like, you know, like in prison or whatever, something like that. And like, it's like sort of vague right now, but I'm just picking up, like, that, like, because of others dying and having those incidents, it's just like he's blaming himself and, like, trying to cause himself the same thing.
Yeah, I see. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so without, no judgment here, we've all done both sides of this
Yeah.
game. Let's just go ahead and do a deep dive into that aspect of Sean's past, where you're sensing it, feeling it, just tune right into the gory details of
Yeah.
what happened, what he did, and
Okay.
that's related to his condition now.
This probably would make sense. I'm looking into the connections, where is it and all. And it's like I visited these galactic federations. I was like involved with them and followed by them and stuff. And you know,
Galactic what?
galactic federations. Like there's like a lot of them, like the whole alphabet structures or whatever. So with all these galactic federations, there's this intergalactic prison, and like you know, whoever like is notorious for whatever reasons, killing or doing too much or whatever, like you know, hey, this being is doing too much, let's get him. So there's this intergalactic prison where you know you have all kinds of species like reptilians, greys, humans, Arcturians, Pleiadians, like all kinds of beings are in there. And with it all, there's a place where they give like rations of how much the prisoners get, eating and stuff like that. And Sean is the one, I think, like responsible for, like n not necessarily setting how much they're gonna get, but he's the one who's gonna give the food and serve them and stuff. And with all that, like he's counting the rations, if that's the right word, of like how much prisoners are gonna get, and not all of them are like satisfied, but in this life, yeah, he has to count like specific rations of how much he can eat. Like, you know, it has to be a very specific amount of food.
Oh, and in that life, he was counting rations for other people.
Yes. Yeah, like he asked, like, you know, that was his orders, like, you know, hey, like, do this and stuff, like, serve the prisoners. And a lot of them were dissatisfied. Like, or, you know, like, I'm looking at a place where, like, you know, someone grabs him throughout the jail cell, like, and hits him or whatever, like, because they, like, you know, were angry and stuff. So there's like various cases, but I'm just like I need to look at deeper into this. But like so far, we're getting more details and so it's making more sense.
Okay, good. Continue.
It seems like in that prison they have very harsh rules of like the discipline, the willpower, all the rules. Everything has to go exactly by the book, and if you don't do it, then they're gonna torture you, like you know, electrify you in the chair, wipe your memories, or like cause some intense pain. Do like there are like lots of variations of how people can get hurt, and you know, counting rations for others while they eat, but also like you know, how much does the crew get, and what if you do a little bit too much, a little bit too little, and you know, if you like you know, hey, I'm starving here, I need a little bit more food, you take one bun or whatever, and then they're like you know, have cameras everywhere. It's like the whole prison is like organic being, and it's. It has ears and eyes everywhere, you know? All the walls is the same organic consciousness being. And it can literally, like, you know, see everything and report to the headquarters or whatever, like, you know, hey, like, boss, we have this going on. And, you know, taking a little bit of more food to survive another day, because it's actually strict, harsh, and not nice in there. And so then they literally electrify you, or, like, they'll plug in some, it's like a pipe plugged into the stomach, causing intense pain or whatever. So like sort of some of these things are just popping up and all.
Now, is this Sean doing it to them, or that it's happening to Sean, or
It's
it's happening?
happening to Sean. Like I saw like you know, Sean is like working in a prison ward, and he's more like you know, like he has to take care of the prisoners, give them food and different things, write all the like little details, but he's like one of the guards there or something, like just one of the workers in there in the prison. And you know, that's where you know he has to count rations for everyone. That's like one of the bigger signs, like you know, that stands out. Another one, like you know, if you take a little bit too much, you're trying to be kind, like you know, trying to take care of others, or you're trying to survive yourself, and then you get punished for that. And that's like electrifying the pain and stuff like that. That would be
So
like.
if he eats too much, more than his ration, he will get a lot of pain or discomfort and
Well.
stuff going on with him.
After the torture, like
Yeah,
you know,
after the
they're
torture.
gonna torture him or
Yeah.
do whatever, but yeah.
Yeah.
And like that's where like the whole thing of I can't call it a paranoia, but like you have to get everything right. You go a bit wrong and not do it by the book, you're gonna be in pain. And so in order to survive, you have to do everything exactly as they say. And you have to wash absolutely everything, every single detail, every single dust, and like a little thing like, oh, you forgot to clean this table, you forgot this one little speck of dust, and then they sit you down and they cause you, like, you know, the, like, charge electricity and do different things and, like, you know, torture you.
Wow.
Or whatever. So that's very strict place. Like, I think that the guards are having even more of life than the prisoners themselves.
Yeah. Wow. Okay.
So I'll look deeper into this whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Okay, so like, I'm looking into, like, you know, the story of, like, why is Sean there, like, you know, was the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently, like, you know, there's a specific training. It's probably connected to the Galactic Federations or, like, some bigger communities, organizations out there. And you have to be a guard to level up. Like, it's a specific strict rules.
Mm-hmm.
And with the longer you play as a good one, like, you know, you do everything as they say, when you get specific discipline and they become, like, trustful or, like, you know, consider you as being loyal now, then they give you more orders. Like, you know, hey, now you're the captain of this place, now you can do more. But with every level up, there's more access to information.
Mm-hmm.
Information to prisoners and their lives and their backstories, like, you know, what you get, like, as above as the guard. Like, when you're guard, you can hear stories from prisoners, but how much of that is true or not, you don't know. But then you level up, and now you have access to the archives of all the prisoners in there. So you can find out their backgrounds, where they came from, who they are, the things that they did, and it's sort of, like, all of them, I don't know, like, has a sort of implant, or, like, it's like RFID chip or something like that, where you can actually access all of their thoughts, the whole thinking process. And it's very similar to Matrix, to where they can connect you, and you download the program and know everything about it, and you
mm-hmm.
learn all the skills. So you literally, like, just touch it, or like, you know, like a fingerprint scan, and you hold it, and you literally access information, and you get, like, get it all in front of your eyes, and you can just, like, really, like photographic memory or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So there's that, and once you become, like, the head of the this prison, you get offered, like, you know, you can become the organic consciousness and control it, and, like, you know, even tell what kind of prisoners we need to get and stuff. Like, you start controlling orders, or you can go to these, like, galactic archives where they have even more stuff, and be like guardian there, like, you know, like making sure that all the archives are, like, in order, like, protecting that place. But in your free time, you can access absolutely all the information, all of the galactic history, all of the events, like spaceships or whatever, like, you know, you're gonna get the blueprints and all of that. And, like, Sean is after the information. He loves learning. He loves all this difficult stuff that is challenging for most people to learn. He's really good at it.
Mm-hmm.
He's really talented, and he can go for it. But that's the thing, like, you know, he has to go through this rough training until he can reach that place.
Uh-huh, yeah.
And like, one of those, like, you know, hey, I want to live, I want to survive, I want to do everything I can until I get there. And so, like, the whole strict life there, I think, like, it done a lot of harm to how it is with all the pain, which is probably seen at some points in this life.
Yeah, his activities in this life are triggering that issues in that life, or the
yeah, like, you know, like cellular memory or whatever, and you can just, like, walk through the room and there's dust there, and that might be a trigger because you forgot to clean up the dust in the air place, and not cleaning dust means, like, you know, hey, you're gonna get, like, a zap and stuff, be careful. So
mm-hmm.
tons of triggers.
Yeah, okay, yeah, definitely. Okay, next, let's
I'll try to redo the traumatic instance, like, you know, just leave all the
do
memory. I'll try to redo the traumatic instance,
uh-huh.
like, leave all of his memory and experience there, but make sure that anything that hurt him, all of the bad agreements, decisions, or anything that, like, caused pain, I will remove that so that it wouldn't be affecting the present.
Yeah, if you spot the decisions, and the agreements made, and the intentions that.
I'm picking up another thing, like, you know, when he's zapped, and if anyone's talking in the background, it becomes a command. That's another thing to check, like, all the incidents where he was unconscious, and what happened in the background, like, as if, like, that might be a thing.
That's definitely a thing.
Okay.
Okay.
Hmm. Like, I'm looking at it, and, like, the whole prison system, and those more of in charge and stuff, they will scan everyone, like, whoever wants to work and stuff, they can, like, literally connect it to the machine, get you unconscious and access your memories, so they will know absolutely everything. Like, you know, like they can literally like watch a movie with what you've experienced, and they can alter it. They can alter your memories and stuff.
Wow.
But so like it's like they access one's memories, and they copy the file, they copy recording, and they know you, the truth about who you are. But then every prisoner who's in there will get change in their history and their memories. So whoever there, they cannot tell or reveal their true intentions or real life. So all of them are telling fake stories, but for them it's real.
Wow.
And so like whoever's working there, they might try to get information from prisoners, and it's never gonna work, because like you're always getting the false information, while only the head will, like, you know, like the controllers or whoever rules the place will know this stuff. And once you level up, this is when you start accessing those files.
Mm-hmm.
And Sean, in one of those places where he gets zapped, that's when they start like looking at your head, like what you have, what's your intentions, who you are, and stuff like that.
Yeah,
So it's quite a rough place.
Yeah. Okay. Continue.
It seems that this prison, even though it's like very harsh, it's working in order to write the galactic history, or like the multiverse history.
Correct it?
Just write it. Like
just rewrite it, or
just write it.
Write it.
Yeah.
Write as in writing with a pen and pencil, or write as in right and wrong. Correct it. Write.
Like write it with the pen and pencil.
Oh, okay.
But more like true on their computers and stuff.
Oh, I see.
Like every being they access, they will like get all of this information, like what he learned, what he studied, everything he saw, everything he said and heard and stuff. All the history of the person will be taken from them, and then it's modified in order to, like, you know, hey, we have to make sure that both sides, the good ones and the bad ones, they keep changing it all the time. We don't know what's going on. We have to make it, like, there has to be at least one explanation of things.
Mm-hmm.
So everyone that's, like, captured for whatever reasons, their memories are altered so that, like, whenever they're free or whatever, they might tell stories, but it's never gonna reveal the real stuff.
Uh-huh.
And so only that specific group that works in the prison, they're gonna record everything and more like keep things straight, at least for them. They know what's up. They know what's up in the planets and different things, and it's very strict for reasons. You know, like, they have their own explanation, everyone does.
Yeah.
But so Sean, he gets through being a guard, he levels up, now he has to be the one that does the rewriting of the history or the memories of others.
Uh-huh.
So he's the one wiping the memories of others. And, you know, having to, like, type down, like, you know, everything about his being was learned. And basically, they're, like, they're very organized. Every single race has their thing. Every single issue is regarding, like, you know, like, everything's, like, grouped. And whenever there's something similar, they compare it and see how truthful it is. Like, how many things like that. And, like, you know, they're, like, trying to explain things for themselves. Like, understand how things work and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's what I'm picking up so far.
Okay. Good.
It all seems like, you know, it's like a research place where everything they do with these prisoners is basically a test. Let's see how this race reacts to this. And every single race will have a different reaction. Every single race will have a different outcome and all. And so, like, you know, just changing the rations of food is one thing, but then changing the activities, changing the conversations, changing with who you talk to, how you talk to, like, tons of different ways of variations of how they're going to do it. And it's like they're studying the psychology, or like how do these beings react. So like every race is written about, like, you know, like how reptilians work, how the Anunnaki, how like humans or Pleiades, like everyone will have a specific reaction. And they're like mapping out what kind of beings do we have in the universe, what's the order, how do they like both communicate or collide, or like get in fights and why and stuff like that. So like just going like really deep into all this stuff.
Yeah.
In their own ways.
Yeah, good. Continue.
Yeah, there's a lot to learn here. Like, I'm looking like deeper into the structure, like what's above the prison, what's next. And this like archives where we were talking about, it's more than that. It's like the work is the place of like having archives and the story or like history of all the races, all the like places and different things, but at the same time it's like working like an information center, because like when some of the groups will go on missions, like, you know, they have to tell about what they're gonna do. It's like people are playing in the multiverse and they're like, hey, we're gonna play in this place, this is what we're gonna do, we're gonna fight these guys here and here. And so that other guys wouldn't get in the way or wouldn't get in the fight, they're making sure, like, you know, like, hey, this place has a traffic, don't go there, go around that. So it's very weird, but it's like everything's like planned out, and like, you know, even though we're calling them bad guys or good guys or whatever, both sides agree that like, oh, okay, we're gonna duke it out here, others can go around us.
Yeah, it reminds me of the idea once again of when we were wiser, bigger, better beings, both sides being dark or light or good and bad or whatever. But there was a time when we played games, and it's just like in a computer game. Everybody's going to log in, but before you log in, everybody, let's touch bases and make sure that mages can do this, but these kind of mages can't do that. And this is, you'll be in this race of orc or that Nord or whatever, get all set up before you go in and play. But then when you go in and play, you duke it out, and you battle it up and fight it out. But back in those days, you could blow real shit up, and it's okay. We were beyond that, that part of the problem of gameplay. But I don't know sure exactly where what you're looking at fits into the context of these levels of gameplay in universes, but yeah, that's what I reminds me of.
Yeah. So like there's a lot to it. Like I'm looking at it like one thing after another, like it's all news, like what was this, was this, was this, like you know, like it's there's a lot to digest and all. But it seems like in order to work there, like in that center in the marketplace and stuff, you have to kill all the urges. Like not be selfish, not have any like, you know, you can't have your own intentions of like, hey, I'm gonna do this when I get there and whatever. Like you have to really forget about it, and if you don't, you can never get to that level. And even if you do get to that level somehow, it's like if you fuck it up, you're gonna be hunted and you're gonna be killed. Like this is really like in a wanted level high and it's like whatever. But basically, you can't use that place in order to get information about other race and then use it against someone else. You can't sell information. You can't you do anything bad with it, you know? You can't use it in any sort of way except like learn more because you like it and you want it.
Sure, it makes
And
sense.
you know, so with all that, like you can access all the archives, and it's like I don't know, like being an architect in Matrix, where you constantly have an out-of-body experience and you can visit absolutely everything. It's like taking an artifact and literally moving into it and seeing everything for yourself, hearing all the confirmations, because like you know, some people can read about it, some people can hear it on audio track, but like they're giving all the access of like all the way of accessing information, and you can literally have an out-of-body experience and be there and see everything for yourself with explain like you know the intentions of this party, intentions of this party, and how it all happened and why the conversation is like there. It's like watching a movie with a background text of every single character and their like sort of whatever. So like you know, and you can visit one URL after another. Like all of the beings and like races and planes and existence, like it's really amazing of how much is there. And in that center, like you know, you can there's archives of information, but there's also like you know archives, and it's like someone's working in the game and servers and stuff, and they can unplug and plug different places, so to make sure that it can all happen like on one level. But always keeps teleporting to a different place, connected and disconnected, to make sure that some parties, if they want to duke it out or do something in a certain place, they don't mess, like get in the way of each other. So, like you know, for example, you're a spaceship, like you know, with a crew, and you're going somewhere, and now you need materials. You call the center, report them what kind of materials you need, and you know, like now they can give you information to the planets and stuff, and then you know. They want to see what kind of game you're playing. Do you want to like you know kill them? Do you want to like you know collide and stuff? Like what's your mission? Is it are you friendly or not? And then there's like list of like choices. Like so it's like everything is tracked, all of the history is tracked. And in order to be there, you have to be like pure. But it's like hardcore training together. So it's like it's one of the things that Sean is doing. And that sort of thing. Like being there is what causes the sort of like very hard rules in life. A little incident, a little worries and stuff. You cannot pass. You cannot go further. And in order to grow and be the most you can be, you have to be very strict with their rules for that place. So that's what I'm finding out so far.
Wow. Well, do you want to look some more, or is that a good place to wrap, or what?
I'll look into like Sean's involvement into it all, like, you know,
his what?
Sean's involvement,
uh-huh.
and like see like what happens next,
uh-huh.
and go from there.
Okay.
It's very interesting. Like, there's lots of things, but it seems that the beings who go like even above that, what they become is the parallel universe. Literally, like, consciousness becomes the parallel universe.
Wow.
And it extends the creation of the all existence. And, like, you know, like, then you can alter, like, you know, hey, now you know absolutely everything, and you can make your own alterations to the all the events, all the history, all the beingness and stuff, and just create different life forms and just extend the possibilities.
Wow.
And so it seems like one time or one lifetime thing, but for people who choose to, like, you know, they don't go over top to expand it, if they decide to quit or like get in our life or do something else and like, hey, I quit, this is enough, I'm done,
mm-hmm.
Their memories have to be wiped because they cannot use that in somewhere else. They, like, you know, oh, I know a lot about this history,
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna anchor it somewhere else and I'm gonna use it and stuff. That cannot happen, sort of against the rules.
Sure.
So they try to mind, like, you know, like delete everything they can, like, you know, wipe the whole existence. And even if the consciousness can tap into those experiences, because it can,
mm-hmm.
and the structure cannot stop it, then you become targeted by their machines, by different things, and they will sort of cause a traumatic instance to recreate, like, all the pains and different things. Or now, like, the life will have certain, like, difficulties or whatever, and there's, like, increasing the challenge of existence or living or whatever,
mm-hmm.
and they like keep trying to prevent one from being able to access all the memories.
Uh-huh.
So that's like picking up some of the things. Like, it's weird. There's a lot to it. I'm like, whoa, but I've never been here before.
Yeah. Wow. That's amazing. It has a little bit of the shades of or flavor of the galactic historian Andrew Bartz. He's can tap into the all-knowing galactic history.
Yeah.
So he may have gone through similar training as this. It could be the same thing or something a lot different. There's also another one of this recording. It has to do with Earth, the Living Library.
Mm-hmm.
That's the Pleiadians. Barbara Marciniak wrote a book on that subject, Earth, the Living Library.
Yeah.
And that's an attempt, or the project was to load up all the data and the memory and the history of our universe,
mm-hmm.
into the Earth, the organic life on Earth, the Living Library, they call it. So it looks to me like there are different factions or federations or groups of advanced beings are working at recording the all of it.
Yeah.
And with all that said, they're doing it with different strategic ways or technological ways. There is that other thing. It's just tapping into the mind of God, or the God consciousness of all that is, which is a spiritual psychic way of accessing it yet another way.
Yeah.
And all these other ways are more like high-tech, advanced, super high-advanced technology ways of doing these things.
Mm.
So that's what I'm getting, that there's different kinds and flavors and ways of the groups trying to work in the memory of the galaxy thing. And then you tapped into this particular one that Sean got caught up in.
Yeah, totally. Like, you know, with all the alterations and groups out there, like, there's so many alphas out there.
Mm-hmm.
So many. And, you know, to say that this is the only way it happens, it would be a complete lie. Like,
yeah.
If, no, like, there's tons of different groups now, but, like, it's really interesting to see how it works.
Yeah.
Because literally, like, at some points, like, they, it's as if everything is happening on the same plane. There's no above or below. It's everything, like, on the same plane. It's just that someone's clicking buttons and turning it off and turning it in and, like, changing it up for others, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's weird, like, I still have to, like, understand that better, but
wow.
It's interesting.
Yeah, good stuff.
Yes, yeah, so with all that being done, we found information, we found the story, we found the lore. Now it's going through all of that and just sort of clearing all the stuff that might trigger Sean and, like, you know, cause any problems and stuff.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay.
I was thinking, just start, I'm sorry to interrupt you. Spotting decisions and agreements and conclusions, like after things have been done, a person will conclude, you know, draw a conclusion, this is the way, this is what that was, this is the takeaway, and then that becomes a belief within the consciousness. And those basic beliefs can carry through from one life to another. And
yeah,
to the present life.
That's a good thing to look at as well.
Okay, go ahead. That.
Look specifically, like, there's either decisions or beliefs or whatever, but it's like everything has to be by the book. It has to be controlled. There has to be some laws and something strict and, like, the way it's supposed to be and all that. Everything has to be explained in, like, you know, with all the, like, scientific whatever terms. Because that openness to, like, all the possibilities means that, you know, like, hey, we're gonna catch hell for that. Don't do that. Like, you know, in that place, in that structure where he was living and doing things, you can't be open to all this stuff. You can't be that free. And having freedom right now is dangerous. It's gonna be harmful. It's gonna hurt you. It's gonna, like, it's not good to do that, because, like, eventually you're gonna catch shit for that. And so everything has to be, like, specifically, like, in one way or another. So much, like,
sure.
A few dinos.
Yeah, continue.
It's like there's this, probably still our memory, but it's as if, like, whenever he's living here and part of his consciousness can recall the experiences and access the information of things that happened and, like, just get this vast knowledge, his body is in a big resistance and it has these shock waves. It reacts with, like, pain or, like, just rejecting everything, rejecting information, rejecting food, rejecting life, everything, you know. And so the body is, like, in sort of, like a programmed thing. And not necessarily from the present, but, like, because of all the past torturing and stuff.
Sure, yeah.
So that's one of the things.
Okay. Do you want to look some more?
Yeah.
Okay.
Another thing, like, that place, it's as if, like, you know, it has that military lifestyle or some sort of organization group lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
So everything is timed and scheduled and, like, there's a way how you do things, but you do it as a community. And by being off by yourself, you don't, if you forget the schedule, it's gonna, again, hurt you. So even, like, living alone or being alone for a certain period of time and just having to make decisions of your own can be hurtful. If you forget anything, if you forget one smallest detail or not think about it. And so in this life, it's probably, like, pays back where, like, you know, hey, if you're alone, if you're thinking too much, little worries, it's gonna come back at you. Like, you know, you're just gonna, like, really worrying about surviving and doing it right to achieve that stuff, and, you know, you can't mess it up, and it's really, like, really controlling his life here.
Yeah, so in this life he's gotten a lot of triggers triggering this stuff.
Yeah, it's as if, like, because of the harsh training and the torture out there, this body, or, like, subconsciously, it's all reacting right now in the present.
Sure, yeah.
It's smallest things will catch him and, like, really get him. So, yeah,
okay.
Just saying.
Yeah. Okay, continue.
It's as if, like, there's that prison place or whatever, like, that's the whole structure and the organization. They have quite a few other squads to monitor things away from their zone. Like, in, like, every realm and stuff will have those little goons and whatever. Call them whatever, like, I don't know, but it's like people who want you to believe in God and church, and they're pushing their beliefs on you. So they can be invisible, or they can turn it invisible and stuff, but they will be around people who visited with that place even once, doesn't matter how long they stayed in there and stuff. It's like going, like, you know, pushing them into, like, you know, hey, you have to do this, you have to do that, and, like, they're constantly pushing and trying to impact, affect the person, like, influence them, if that's the right word. And one is, like, you know, affecting their thinking and stuff. The other one is, like, you know, they're still under that strict regime And if a person is having a more free lifestyle, they're gonna be triggered. It's like those little things that have a pointing stick or whatever, like, you know, like they will harm the being.
Prod, like a
Kind of
cattle
like,
prod, sort of bzz, bzz,
yeah.
but metaphysically or metaphorically speaking.
Yeah, and you know, so like these beings are trying to force one to live under those rules again, because like that's the lifestyle, and it's also like a way to prevent from accessing all the memories and just remembering everything, because the more they can like sort of trigger little things and push them into a certain way, the being will do things, but it's basically like being under control, and like you know, hey, if an animal will not take a photo with people, it's gonna get smacked or whatever, like you know, like that kind of thing. So, like constant triggers, constant worries and thoughts and different things. Whatever they can trigger, whatever they can find your buttons and all the stuff, they're gonna do it. So that's another thing that's happening. I was like reviewing all the incidents and then I just found this group, like, you know, hey, what are you guys? So I just kinda
Wow.
get rid of them.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, like this seems like I'm getting rid of these entities and I'm like looking at the soul contracts right now. And this organization has the sort of like a pact or like contract or whatever, like whenever you get in there, you cannot use your information or memories for a few billion years. Because after a few billion years, you will do so many things that you don't even want to use that information. You know, so they're like we trying to like have enough time pass until they allow you to live normally again.
Yeah, I see. That makes
Yeah,
sense.
so it's like being under some sort of group and they're like controlling you then.
Agreements made way in the past, coming affecting you now.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'll see like what kind of agreements he has with his group and all and whatnot.
Okay, good.
Actually like these agreements and different things were like, you know, we have to live under a specific discipline. Like there are like tons of different disciplines and everyone can have their own, but it has to be specifically those that organization discipline. Not being able to access the memories, not being able to share it with other people, not being able to do this and that and that. Tons of different things. And if anyone around you has the ability to help you to remember those things, to access the things, memories and the you know, whatever, it's like there's insider organism or whatever to reject that, to push it away, to like you know, be made to go the other direction, to like sort of hey, don't look at that, you know,
Repel.
kind of like yeah.
Being repelled or repulsed or pushed away or, oppressor beams.
Yeah, so like you know, whenever you can access or use the things to recall everything that happened there to break free or whatever, it's like you know, like people are being repelled. Like you have to be like under sort of strict like you know leash or whatever.
Yeah.
So I'll look for more.
Okay, continue.
Yeah, I'm deleting or like revoking his soul contracts and stuff. And a lot of it has to do with the beliefs from the past life. Like for example, being in a place and collecting information, like the history about every single race and whatever, you start buying into what that race is like. Oh, humans get susceptible to viruses and bacteria, humans get sick, humans die, humans don't live long, for example. Various things, but just because a few people had it doesn't mean that everyone will do. Or like, you know, so basically, those beliefs affect the present, this is how humans are. And you don't have the open look, you have like by the book. And that's how you have to go. So I was like revoking all that because living by the book, you already have your life described to you how it has to be. And you know, so not having freedom, like I'm just like getting rid of that stuff.
Good.
Yeah, so I'll look for the I guess like I'll give him the energy that was used up and all that stuff and look for maybe soul fragments or whatever and we'll go from there.
Okay, good. Continue.
Okay.
Okay, what happened?
Yeah, like I was getting back the soul fragments and just like freeing all the essence, everything that was like you know from the torture, from different things that was taken from him. Like I just like got him back and transmuted it to the good energy and just filling him up with all the good stuff I can find, like you know, energized and really healthy and open, different stuff. And yeah, we'll see how it works.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes.